Well, we love our missionaries here at Covenant Community Church. And if you have your bulletin, you'll see a pink insert that kind of highlights some of the ministries that God has entrusted to our missionaries. And so I'm not going to read anything today. We oftentimes will have a highlight of a missionary and give you an update. But what better to have one face-to-face, alive and in person? We had a wonderful time with John and Pam Wollman this morning during Sunday school, but we've asked them to give an update here on what God has been doing in their hearts and minds as they move forward. Pam grew up here, and so she's one of our daughters. Some 49 years that we have partnered together with them in ministry, and along the way, we inherited a wonderful son named John as well. So I'm going to invite John and Pam to come and share what God has laid on your hearts. Thank you.
Hope in the Lord. For with the Lord there is loving kindness, and with him is abundant redemption. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his loving kindness is everlasting. You are my God, and I give thanks to you. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His loving kindness is everlasting. The Lord has done great things for us, and we are glad. So we come to you today in obedience to the Lord, and to join with the psalmist in saying, thanks to the Lord, for he is good. So many of the important and significant days of my life have been marked right here at Covenant. Mom and Dad came to Covenant when I was 5 years old. I was saved under Pastor Drummond's teaching, baptized here, commissioned here. I actually announced my engagement from this pulpit and was married here. We dedicated our firstborn son here. The memorial services for my grandmas, both of them, my dad, my stepdad, and my mom were all here. My heart is full with so many memories and expressions of love, too many to count, for you are a faithful, loving congregation. What a beautiful heritage you have all blessed our lives. It's been a privilege to serve God with Africa Inland Mission all these years. 49. On my way to the mission field in 1974, my father said, you have to meet the pastor before you go. You're not going to be here for 4 years. So we stopped by the little house over there and greeted Pastor Myers. They had just come and they were staying in that little house. That was the beginning of my missionary career. Thank you for your faith and your trust and your generous spirit that has made all of this possible. There just are not many people who can say someone has stood by them for 49 years on the missionary. You are faithful. We thank God for you. We thank you and pray for you. You rejoiced with us when we had happy things, and you upheld us when our way was hard. And we thank God for you. We appreciate your faithfulness, even though your way has also held many challenges. Together we have stepped out in faith, not knowing all that God held for us, but holding on to his promise to guide us, to be our provider, knowing that he's going to work all things together for our good and for his glory. We have seen God answer countless prayers, knowing that He loves us, cares for us. He sees us. We know when we don't understand His way, we can understand His heart. We can look His heart and trust His heart. We especially appreciated the counsel of Pastor Myers and your faithful encouragement to us during our struggles between assignments, supporting us and loving us as we moved from our service in Africa to our service in the home office in New York. We loved our time in the little missionary house that used to be over there. Our kids learned to ride bikes in the parking lot. They learned about toasters and TV and hockey. And Santa Claus even made a visit to that house one year. Andrew was talking to my dad and he goes, "You know, Grandpa, it was really my voice for Gate Leader." Just happy days with good news. We wanted to come in person and say thank you for allowing us to be your hands and your feet, the extension of you, so people in Africa could know about Jesus. There are people in heaven because you came. They will be eternally grateful. And together, we will all worship the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords for all eternity. I'm going to introduce you to some of those people. So, I want to say, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make His face shine down on you and be gracious to you. May the Lord lift up His countenance upon you and give you peace.
There's a song that we have started singing. I don't know how old it is. All my life you have been faithful. I can't remember the rest of it. Oh, yeah, you've been so, so good. And with every breath that I am able, I will sing the praises of God. And when we first started singing that, it was just so true. That was just summed up what we've experienced in our lives, the faithfulness of God. And you have certainly been a part of that. Multiple times, we'll just read through the Psalms, you can hear the psalmist say, well, that he would publicly declare before the congregation the goodness of the Lord, faithfulness of the Lord, or things that the Lord has delivered him from. And so it's very fitting that we stand before our congregation here and declare the same things. God has been so, so faithful. And like Pam said, oh, give thanks to the Lord, for He is good. And of course, His goodness is most often seen and experienced through His children who have been obedient in their lives as they just serve Him joyfully. I've personally been blessed through the ministry of Pastor Myers when we were here during transition, and Pastor Steve in particular, and between assignments, trying to sort things out. My greatest blessing that Covenant has blessed me with is, it's been Pamela. And God, the upbringing that she had, her family, and through the ministry of Covenant. And we'd be grateful for being able to experience experienced the love of Jesus through her to me. It's been a real blessing. So heaven has blessed me every day. And we all share, because you're part of our ministry, we all share in what the Lord might have done. We don't know all that he has accomplished through our ministry with Africa and our mission. But thank you for being a constant partner in our service to the Lord. I like to ponder verses. I like to sit and think about, what's really going on here? And one of them is kind of a blessing, but it's kind of rich in what it says. At the end of Hebrews, may the God of peace, who brought up from the dead, through the great shepherd of the sheep, through the power of the blood of the covenant, equip you and us for every good work. And this is the part that I keep coming back to. He says, working in us what's pleasing to him. And through the struggles, we can just keep that in mind. God is working in us what is pleasing to him. And all through Jesus Christ, to whom we glory forever and ever. Amen?
Amen.
And thank you for being with us in our midst.
Before you run off, we want to thank you for your faithfulness as a missionary pilot and as a teacher, especially at an MK school. As you know, I'm an MK and I have a very fond memory of my boarding school time as well. And then in the home office, whether that in New York or in the bustling city of Atlanta, we are so thankful for the opportunity that we have had to stand with you all. Let's approach that great shepherd of the sheep. Father, thank you so much for John. Thank you for Pam. Thank you for their faithfulness to you. We thank you, Father, that indeed, because of that faithfulness, we will rub shoulders with Kenyans, with other Africans, and indeed, as Pam has shared, share all of eternity with them. We thank you, Father, for the faithfulness of your people here at this church, who have stood with them, who have given sacrificially, who have prayed, who have cared. We ask, Father, that as they enter this new phase of retirement, that you would make your way crystal clear to them. Help them, Father, in the decision-making as they figure out where they might live, what they might do, what new adventures you might have for them as they follow after you. We entrust them, Father, into your watchful care, and we thank you. We thank you for your faithfulness to them and to us. In Christ's matchless name that we pray. Amen.